I'll just give a small introduction before I start. Usually we don't take political topics, but because this is like a newsroom, I have taken a topic which is political in nature. I'm not some knowledgeable person, but the editorial says that we need to take an editorial stance. So I've taken a stance, no offense given to anybody, and I will start. There's going to be like a director who will give me a cue when to start, and as soon as we can start, I'm going to start very well. I'll be sitting and
Hello, are you ready? Rahul, are you ready?
Yes.
Camera rolling, start, action.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. In this last section of the news hour, today we are going to discuss a conflict that has plagued the nation for 200 years. It was in 1837 that the Kingdom of Mysore and the Madras Presidency had an agreement about the Kaveri water. And till today, we have not been able to solve this issue of distribution of water. Even today, conflicts are continuing. I want to say today that the real reason that this has not been brought to a closure is because fundamentally we are looking at a wrong problem. We are looking at a problem of distribution, which means that if there is a pie, you get a certain part and I get a certain part. However, if the pie is not small enough, if the pie is not big enough, everybody is going to go hungry. It does not matter how fairly you distribute it. And until we shift this fundamental thinking from distribution to creation of water, we are not going to solve this problem. 200 years, it was the British who tried to solve it. It was the kings who tried to solve it. It has been the government of India that has tried to solve it. Tribunal after tribunal has tried to solve it. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is the bane of the country today. I want to take a minute to tell you about the logistics of conflict. When a rally has to be organized, you have to hire trucks. You have to hire stages, you have to create food, and all of this costs millions and millions of rupees. Money that can easily have been used to create lakes. Instead of one rally, you can create one lake. And had this been done over 200 years, I assure you both of these states would have been water surplus states. But what we have found instead, in both situations, without taking any sides, Bangalore at one time had more than 200 lakes, today it has only 89. And the water table has dwindled and dwindled and dwindled. Chennai at one point had more than 200 lakes. Today it has 125. There is a flood situation in that one city, which is a representative of what has happened to the environment throughout the country. If the leaders had taken a long-term view and focused on creation, I assure you there would have been enough water for everybody today. We need to understand two things. Number one, nobody is to blame. The minute you get into blame, which is what our leaders are so good at doing, you cannot be in the creation mode. You're going to blame somebody and all that energy goes into this conflict. The fundamental shift that has to happen is that we need to recognize that everybody's needs are important. Whether it is a farmer in Tamil Nadu or a farmer in Karnataka, their needs matter. Whether it is an industrialist in Tamil Nadu or an industrialist in Karnataka, their needs matter. And if we are going to create any kind of solution, then everybody has to be included. And the only solution is to create more. If we see examples of Rajasthan and Bhopal, they have created water bodies that have met their needs today. Rajasthan, a dry state, has today become the granary of the country. I want to say, as one country, we need to find the solution and commit to it today. Thank you.